Hello everybody, hope you're doing okay. I've got a new shoe today. This is the ASICS Road Blast. Now you might have heard of the ASICS Nova Blast, which is this orange one here. But this is kind of a similar shoe to the Nova Blast, but it's a much more streamlined shoe and it's much cheaper. Now the key thing is it's got a flight foam blast midsole here, just a small section of it, whereas the Nova Blast has the flight foam blast basically, as far as I can tell, the whole way down, and stack height is a bit higher. So this is a 31-21 stack height in the Nova Blast in a size 9, I think. And then it's 24-14, the official figures, in a 9 for the Road Blast. So I fancy this one because, it was very cheap. I got it from Pro Direct for £90, whereas the Nova Blast, I think it's currently retailing in the UK for about £120. So it's already £30 cheaper. And also when I weighed it in my size, it comes up at 303 grams, which bizarrely is the exact same weight as the Nike Alphafly, which is probably the most expensive shoe you could buy at the moment. If you compare that to the Nova Blast in a UK 13 is 340 grams. Now, actually, although I got a 13 in the Nova Blast, that's probably the most roomy shoe that I've got. So in this one, the Road Blast, I actually dropped down to a 12. What's interesting, if you actually look at the box and the centimetre figure there, and it's saying 30.5. Normally the centimetre size is referred to sort of like the actual length of the shoe. So normally in a 13, that would say 32 centimetres for me. But I think in ASICS, they actually refer to the size of your foot. Now my foot, when I measured it, was 30.2 centimetres, both left and right, pretty much the same. So a shoe that is, it says there 30.5 should be ideal for me. But it's never quite clear in these things because I in a New Balance, I go as high as the 13.5. And in Adidas, I have a 12.5 and perhaps wish they did a 13. And Nike, I can just about get away with a 12, but it's very tight. So I generally always go for a 13. So probably this is the most roomy 12 that I've got. So if you're not sure what size and you're sort of going up or down a size, then I'd probably say you could probably get away with a slightly smaller size in an ASICS. Now, what did I think about the actual Road Blast? Well, I thought this was a great shoe for £90. So let's go through some of the tech. So the upper is a sort of a rather one-piece knit construction, they say. You kind of feel it doesn't look too breathable, but I've been out for 2 10-mile runs now in them, and it was fine. It's obviously summer here in the UK, and it's not overly cold, but my feet didn't get overly hot either. Perhaps I could do with a bit more breathability if you were in any more warmer climate than this, but it's not too bad, nice and comfortable. Another thing to note about the upper on this shoe is, according to the ASICS website, the knit pattern is supposed to be designed to be gender specific. Not entirely sure what that means, but apparently the men's version is different to the women's version. Obviously, I don't have the women's version to hand to tell you exactly what the difference is and whether you would even notice that, but it all looks sort of a fairly standard material. We're just going straight across, so God, if you know what that means, let me know in the comments, please. The big thing for me about the Road Blast over the Nova Blast, it actually comes up, even though I've got a size smaller, that much narrower. The Road Blast potentially had too much material at the front, and I felt I was just forever trying to fight it, and with the laces. I mean, just picking up the two shoes, even though this is obviously the higher size, this one, the Road Blast just feels so much more lighter. But in compensation, it doesn't have flight flame blast across the whole way. So although it's got flight flame blast there, I think it's actually got a slightly cheaper flame called AmpliFoam across the top here. And I think the flight flame blast bit is the heel bit, which looks very similar to what you see in the Nova Blast. Now, that means that as the stack height is a bit lower anyway, and you don't have the flight foam blast across the whole length of the shoe, this is much more a firm and responsive shoe, which I actually quite like. And I found this extremely similar shoe to like the Brooks Launch 6, or maybe some of it also reminds me a lot of the Adidas Boston series. I've got a Boston 9 coming soon, so I'm looking forward to comparing that with that. But certainly for a shoe that you would want to sort of take out for sort of just general training, but don't want something that just feels really heavy, this was great. And it felt, there was certainly enough cushioning in it to last me for that 2 10-mile trips. Although they do say on their website, it's only meant to be short runs. I think it's meant to be sort of like a low to mid-range shoe designed perhaps for people that are doing 20, 30 miles a week. So the fact that I've actually already done 20 miles in it over 2 runs is quite encouraging. and I certainly didn't, my legs didn't feel beat up today after the 10 miles yesterday. So working back through the shoe, the lacing was rather traditional, eyelets in, nothing fancy that at all. The tongue is sort of fairly thin, there's a bit of cushioning in it, but it's not as plush as some of the shoes. That obviously keeps the weight down, and there's a little tab there so that you can keep it like a one piece and get your foot in easier. There's no pull tab, but I didn't find any particular problem getting it on. One thing I did notice perhaps that the laces, you felt that you almost wanted one more eyelet chain. This is quite a long gap between the front and the top and the laces, and I had to pull the laces in a bit, but as I said, it was much narrower than the Lova Blast, and for me with a very narrow foot that suited me. Some with a wider foot may find that this is not as accommodating as the Lova Blast, but certainly this felt like a lot more compact when I was on foot. The heel tab is quite well cushioned for a shoe of this thing. Again, it reminds me rather like the Brooks Launch 6, quite well cushioned there. It did sort of irritate me slightly the first time I wore them, thinking it was almost a bit too much there, because it doesn't have the traditional sort of cutaway that you expect on the more modern sort of higher range shoes now. But as a person that's sort of recovering from Achilles tendon issues, I'm almost a bit wary of that. So but it felt fine on those two runs. I haven't got any discomfort at all, so that was good. It does have the option to do the double lace loop if you want to. Haven't yet, and actually for once in a shoe, I haven't got a huge amount of extra lace. I can do a double knot and don't need to hide away the laces so much. So just taking a look at the underside of the shoe, it's kind of similar in a way to the Nova Blast, isn't it? You can see the Road Blast on the top and the Nova Blast on the bottom. This sort of central cutaway, and you can sort of see the green foam there as well, although you can't see any green foam there, so I'm not quite sure where that colour is. But I did mostly my road runs in those two 10 miles. I did a very short section of trail, which was like a footpath through some trees, but it was a bit soggy underfoot, but not too bad. So as you can see that I haven't really got the muddy, so it can't have been too bad. But yeah, no problems at all with the grip, and my tend to sort of toe off there, so I need to watch how that rubber is. But there's nice, quite a lot of rubber on the toe off there. And there's certainly all the places that you typically land in the forefoot and the heel. So shouldn't really have any problems with that. So for a shoe for £90, I think this represents really good value. And the shoes of a similar price point that I've got, probably the SL20, I've got the Boston 9 coming in. So it'd be interesting to see how they fare. I think I would have put the Brooks Launch up against them, but I had the 5 and the 6 and really liked them and found this quite a similar shoe. But I've heard that the 7 was really sort of quite harsh and got really bad reviews, so I never bothered picking that one up. So if you like shoes that just aren't too heavy on foot, I think that something like this is a really good option. And also the fact that it's actually £90 is about half the price of some of the shoes that are coming out at the moment, which have got these plates in and all that stuff. But for general training, yeah, something like this seems to me to work fine. So for most of your daily runs, do you really need a shoe that's got all these bells and whistles in it when you're just going and getting your base mileage all the time? My feeling is probably not, and I just want to put on a shoe sometimes for some of those easy runs that isn't feeling like I'm having to work harder than I have to just to get in, say, my 8-minute miling compared to, say, sub 7-minute miling I want to do in a marathon and 6-minute miling, say, in a 10K. Having said that, when I actually wore this shoe last night, I did a bit of city strides where I jump up and down cul-de-sacs. So as Ed Budd would say, if you need a review issue, you need to run up a few cul-de-sacs, don't you? Well, rather more than a few cul-de-sacs. So I certainly put it for its paces. When I actually got onto the open road, as it were, I found, looking at my pace, I was easily dropping it down to the low 7s without much effort. So I thought, for quite a budget type shoe, I thought that was quite a good indication. This is actually, you know, not actually a slow shoe, as it were, at all. Quite the reverse. So I hope you found this interesting, and look forward to seeing you on the next one. Okay, bye.